Good morning, students. I hope all of you are doing well. You must have done well in your test. Today, in this lecture of Mathematics Class 8, I will discuss the test solutions of Chapter 10, Visualizing Solid Shapes. So, today's topics are, I will discuss the test solutions. Then, I will give you assignment 1 of chapter 1, rational numbers, as your homework part. So, as you are well aware that the test was divided into 4 sections, so let us discuss section A, 1 marks question. The very first question was, the line segments where the faces of a polyhedron meet are called edges. So, the line segments where the faces of a polyhedron meet are called edges. We have learnt about faces, vertices and edges. So, the line segments where the faces of a polyhedron meet are called edges. The answer of first question is edges. Coming to second question, a rectangular prism is also known as. In this, you were supposed to tell the another name of rectangular prism, and you must know what do you mean by a prism. What is a prism? A polyhedron whose base and top are congruent polygons and whose lateral faces are parallelograms in shape is called a prism. But what is specifically a rectangular prism? A prism whose base and top are congruent rectangles and lateral faces are rectangles. So that is a rectangular prism, and definitely all the 6 faces are rectangles, so it will be a cuboid. So the other name of rectangular prism is cuboid, or a rectangular prism is also known as cuboid. Now, next question is, you were supposed to define a prism. What do you mean by a prism? Solution of this is, you are supposed to simply write the definition of prism. So, if the top and bottom of a polyhedron are congruent polygons and its lateral faces are parallelogram in shape, then it is said to be a prism. Simple as this. Then these are the figures of a prism. First one is your rectangular prism. Second one is your triangular prism. As you all know that prisms and pyramids are named after its base. So the base of first one is rectangle, so it is a rectangular prism. Second one, in the second figure, the base is a triangle, so it is a triangular prism. Coming to fourth question, a solid made up of polygonal regions. Simple, very simple. It was a very simple question. That is a polyhedron. Solid made up of polygonal regions is called a polyhedron, or in short, we can also say that a solid with flat faces or flat surfaces are known as polyhedron. So coming to question 5, give 2 examples of solids which are not polyhedrons. In this question, you were supposed to tell the examples of the solids which are non-polyhedrons. And I told you in the previous question, what are polyhedrons? Polyhedrons are the solids made up of polygonal regions, or the solids with flat faces or flat surfaces are known as polyhedrons. So in this question, we need to give the examples of the solids which are non-polyhedrons. It means the solids which are not having the faces or the surfaces as flat. So spheres and cones are the examples of the solids which are not polyhedrons, or they are non-polyhedrons. You can include cylinders also in this answer. You are supposed to write 2 examples, so you can write any of the 2 out of the 3 known examples. Cones, spheres and cylinders. So the cones and spheres I have written here, you can write cylinder also. So these were the questions of section A, 1 mark questions. Now section B, that is 2 marks questions. Question 6 says, can a polyhedron have 10 faces, 20 edges and 15 vertices? Whenever a question is being asked in which faces, edges and vertices are being given to you, then in that question you are supposed to use the Euler's formula, because this is the only formula which shows the relationship between all these 3 together. So Number of faces are f, that is equal to 10. Number of edges e is equal to 20. Number of vertices v is equal to 15. And we know a polyhedron satisfies the Euler's formula. So according to which f plus v minus e is equal to 2. Simply you are supposed to put the values of faces, vertices and edges to find out whether it is equal to 2, which is the right hand side of the given criteria. If it both the sides, left hand side and right hand side, are equal, then the this formula or this criteria or the given polygon will be a polyhedron, otherwise it will not be a polyhedron. So putting the values 10 plus 15 minus 20, that will be equal to 5, which is not equal to 2 according to the criteria. So the given polygon is not a polyhedron because the Euler's formula is not being satisfied. Coming to seventh question. In a blueprint of a room, an architect has shown the height of the room as 33 cm. If the actual height of the room is 330 cm, then find the scale used by her. We are supposed to use the concept of mapping space around us in this question. And in mapping space, in the concept of mapping space around us, we have learned about the map scales. And then in this, we will be using the scale formula, how to find out the scale if any particular dimensions or the actual height here in this case is given to you, the drawn height is given to you in this question. So let us see what will be the solution of this query question. So an architect has shown the height of the room as 33 cm. Okay, so this is the drawn height. The actual height of the room is 330 cm. Then we need to use, or we need to find the scale used by an architect, that will be drawn size over actual size. So drawn size, what is the drawn size here? That is 33 cm. And what is the actual size here in this question? 330 cm. So putting the values in the formula of the scale, and we will be able to find the final value of the scale. Putting the values of drawn size and actual size in the formula, we will be able to find the scale used by an architect. So putting the values, that is drawn size is 33, actual size is 330. So it will be 1 over 10 after cancelling. So it will be 1:10. This is the map scale. So coming to section C, this consists of 3 marks question. And question number 8 is of 3 marks. Using Euler's formula, find the unknown. We need to use the Euler's formula and find the unknown in this table. So faces, vertices and edges are being given to you, and these are the 3 parts of this question. So we are supposed to find out the first one, we are supposed to find out the faces. In second, we are supposed to find out the vertices, and in the last part, we are supposed to find out the edges. So let us see how we will move further in this question. By Euler's formula, we know that f plus v minus e is equal to 2, where f are the faces of a polyhedron or a polygon, v are the vertices of a polyhedron, e are the edges of a polyhedron. Then f plus 6 minus 12 is equal to 2. So it will be, after solving, f minus 6 is equal to 2. Then this 6 will be shifted to another side and it will be f is equal to 8. So the first part answer, that is faces were unknown in the first part. The faces is equal to 10 in the first part. Now, coming to second part, this is your second part. 5 plus v minus 9 is equal to 2. Here in this second part, we are supposed to find out the vertices. So putting the values of faces and edges in the given criteria, we will be able to find out the value of vertices. So it will be v minus 4 is equal to 2 and v is equal to 6. The first part, in the first part, faces are 8 and in the second part, vertices are 6. Coming to third part, here in this part, we are supposed to find out the unknown value of the edges. So faces and vertices are given to you. So after adding faces and vertices, we will get 32 minus e, that is equal to 2. So e will be 30. So this complete question was based on the Euler's formula. So using the Euler's formula, as Euler's formula defines the relationship between three faces, vertices and edges, three parts of a polyhedron, you can say faces, vertices and edges. If out of these three, two are given to you and one is unknown, then using Euler's formula, you can easily identify the unknown. Now, coming to section D, 4 marks question. This is question number 9. Verify Euler's formula for the given figures. Here, the figures are being given to you. First of all, you need to identify which type of figures are given to you, and then you need to find out the faces, vertices and edges. Then only you will be able to verify the Euler's formula. First of all, you need to identify which type of figures are being given to you. Then you are supposed to find out the faces, vertices and edges of that particular figure, because Euler's formula gives the relationship between faces, vertices and edges. Then after that, you need to verify the Euler's formula for the given figures. First one, let us talk about first figure. What do you say? Which kind of figure is this? Here in the first figure, the base and the top are congruent polygons and lateral faces are parallelograms or rectangles, because rectangle is a type of parallelogram only. So base and top are congruent polygons and lateral faces are rectangles. So yes, definitely it is a prism. But what kind of prism? I told you that prism is named after its base. So the base is hexagon. So it will be a hexagonal prism. So we have identified that first figure is hexagonal prism. Coming to second figure, which kind of figure is second one? Second figure, in the second figure, the base is a polygon and lateral faces are triangles with a common vertex. So this is a pyramid. But what is the name of the pyramid? Here the base has 5 sides, number of sides in the base is 5, so it will be a pentagonal pyramid. So first one is an hexagonal prism, second one is a pentagonal pyramid. So we have identified what are the figures given to you, what kind of figures are being given to you. Now let us see the solution. So let us see first part. In a hexagonal prism, number of sides of the base will be 6, as we have discussed in the figure. So this is the prism, hexagonal prism, and number of sides of the base is 6. Number of faces will be 6 plus 2, that will be 8. Here I have used a particular table which I told you in the revision lecture also, or in the when we were discussing this concept of prism and pyramid. Using that table you can also find out the number of faces, vertices and edges, or the students, those who are comfortable in finding them by looking at the figure only, they can do their own way also, in their own way also. So number of vertices will be 6 into 2, that will be 12. Number of edges is equal to 6 into 3, that will be 18. Now we need to verify the Euler's formula. So we know that f plus v minus e is equal to 2. So putting the values of faces, vertices and edges in this Euler's formula, we will get 8 plus 12 minus 18, that will be 2, which is equal to the right hand side of the given criteria, Euler's formula. So Euler's formula is verified. So we have verified Euler's formula in this case, first case. Let us see whether that will be verified in the second part or not. This is the second part. In pentagonal pyramid, number of sides of the base is 5, and this is the figure. So calculating the number of faces, that will be 5 plus 1 is equal to 6. Number of vertices is equal to 5 plus 1, that is again 6. Number of edges will be 5 into 2, that will be 10. Now we need to verify the Euler's formula. So putting the values of f, v and e in this criteria, then we will get 6 plus 6 minus 10, that will give you 2, that is equal to right hand side of the formula. So Euler's formula is verified. So in both these cases, we have verified, or we have seen that Euler's formula is verified and Euler's formula is fulfilled. So this was the question which you were supposed to do, or to verify the Euler's formula in this question. Now, how to find number of faces, vertices and edges in a polyhedron? I told you one table. I am repeating that table. That is for a prism, faces is equal to s plus 2, where s is the number of sides of the base. Vertices is equal to s into 2, edges is equal to s into 3. And for a pyramid, f is equal to s plus 1, vertices is equal to s plus 1 again, edges will be s into 2. I hope you will be able to remember this table and you can do very easily with the help of this table. Coming to the last question, you are supposed to draw the front view and side view of the given objects. This was the first part. Here, top view, side view and front view you are supposed to make. So what is the solution of this? Clearly from the figure you can see what is the top view. That is the blue rectangles will be the top view. This is the front view, though in, you are not supposed to tell the front view, top view, but I have tried to show you all the three views in this figure. And front view, this is clearly visible from the figure. And side view also, you will be having these two rectangles. And what will be the second part? This was the second part. So top, front and side, it is clearly mentioned from where you are supposed to see at the top. From which is the front side and which is the side view, from where you are supposed to take the side view. So this is the front view in which three dots will be there, side view one dot will be there and top view two dots will be there. These were the solutions of your test. Now let us see the homework part. You are supposed to do the correction work of test in your homework notebook. If there is any wrong question you have attempted, any wrong question, then you can do the correction work. If you are getting full marks, 20 on 20, that is very nice. And you are supposed to try the questions of assignment 1, which I will be giving you in the few next slides. Assignment 1, chapter 1, rational numbers. You can do or try the questions in your practice notebook or in your rough notebook. Or if you are sure enough that the answers are correct, you can directly do those questions in your homework notebook. So this is the assignment 1 of chapter 1, rational numbers. So these are the questions. This assignment has 10 questions. And this is the last question. So you can try the questions of assignment in your rough notebook or practice notebook, or if you are sure enough that the answers are correct, then you can directly do them in your homework notebook and you are supposed to do the correction work of the test solution. Thank you so much.